Hey guys, this is Pwn by Beaner. I finally got my wiring harness in the mail. They lost it, and it took a couple days for them to track it down and everything, but I got it. I already did the unboxing for this Xentec. I'm going to go ahead and be installing it today. This is not going to be a through front-to-back video. I'm just going to stop and go and show you what I did. I don't have a tripod or anything that I can use to hold up my recorder, so I'm just going to be probably giving you guys a quick tutorial on how to install this. If you guys have not taken a look, go ahead and look at my unboxing of the Xentec. These are the 55 watt 8000 K lights. They have like a little bit bluish tint to them. They called it iceberg white, I think it was. But what I'm going to be doing, and I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see this very well, but I'm going to go ahead and show you what my lights look like before and after. I'm in a garage, and so you're probably not going to see the greatest, but I'll go ahead and show it to you guys anyways, and then I'll do a after at night on the freeway or something like that. So as you can tell, these are before. They are the stock ones that obviously came with the car back in 2013. And if you look at, let me go ahead and turn them off. So these are, that's without the lights, it's with the lights. And then if you put the brights on, there's the brights. So I'm going to go ahead they say you don't need to take the rim off because the thing's right here, but I have bigger arms, so I'm going to go ahead and take the rim off anyways. So I'm going to go ahead and move this out of the garage, and I'm going to go ahead and start it, and then I'll keep you guys updated. Okay, first thing you're going to want to do is just undo the wiring harness and make sure it's all exactly the way you want it. It was all bundled up, so it's going to take a little bit of stretching for me to get it back to the way it needs to be. This wire looks like it might be a little bit too short, but I'll make it work. And just put the ballasts where they need to go. Obviously, you're not going to mount them here, but as long as they're sitting right there and you have everything basically where you're going to put it, I'm probably going to put this down here somewhere out of the way, and then same thing for this one. I'll go ahead and put that down inside there if there's enough wiring. And then from that point on, I think I actually can get my arm in there without having to do anything. If I can, there we go. Is the light okay? Up there. I don't know if you guys can see it. It's right here. I need to get that little cap off so we can pull out the factory light. And the same thing on the other side. So I'll go ahead and get that done, and then I'll show you what else I need to do. Okay, so I got this replacer, the factory light out. That was a pain in the ass to get out. I don't know why it was having such an issue, but that thing was stuck in there. Maybe I just have fat fingers or something. I don't know. So we're going to be replacing it with this. But before we do that, we need to make a hole in the... Where did I put it? Oh, there it is. Okay. We need to put a hole in this so the wires can fit through it. Now, this one doesn't have a grommet. It doesn't look like it has a grommet that goes over it, so that's a little bit disappointing. It's not on there either. Okay, so I'm going to have to make a hole. Now, you could use a step drill bit. Those were hella expensive. I didn't care to pay 44 bucks for a step drill bit, so when I had... and did was just bought this. That's a 1 1/4 inch hole saw, and this should do nicely just to put a hole in that and it was only $6, so there we go. I'm gonna go into that, and yeah, okay, I went ahead and made the hole. It didn't do it as clean as I was hoping, and there's whatever, it's a $6 part, a $6 drill bit, so I'm pretty sure the step drill bit would have probably done a whole lot better in terms of coming out fine, but whatever, it's just going under the car anyways. So basically, and then from that point on, it just goes in. Come on, it's hard to do one-handed. Okay, so it just goes in like that. Then you mount the light in, screw the cap on, and the rest is, we'll begin after. Okay. So as you can see, there's three wires. I went ahead and put the cap back on, shoved the wires through it. So you got the three wires. Now we just gotta connect the wiring harness and do the other side. Okay, so I've wired this side. It's just sitting loose for right now, and wired that side just to make sure the wiring is I originally thought it was going to be too short, but it actually is fine. I just got to zip tie some stuff and make it look good on this part. But I went ahead and, as you can see down there, I connected the wires. There's three of them. I couldn't video record it because it was just too much, not enough room. I would have had to have taken the wheels off in order to show you guys. But as you can see, if I can zoom in, there's some wires right there. There goes my dad. Anyways, so I got all that part. I just gotta connect the negative and the positive, and I gotta finish wiring the passenger side. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn the wheels and get started on that. Okay, one thing you guys might be asking yourself whenever you receive this package is, what the fuck are these for? Don't use them. I was looking for a reason to use them, and I think they're extensions, maybe for a different model, but it didn't work. So I just disconnected it, and it there was enough room to use the wiring. So don't even worry about it. Okay, so I went ahead and got this wired. Everything is good. Let's see. Can't really see the wires, but they're there. I did have enough room so I can actually put that right there. I'm going to wire it through the back of the engine. And then I just got to put in the negative ground and the positive. I've already started to loosen this. It's really cold out here. My hands are freezing, but should be done in like 10 minutes. Okay, so I have it connected to the ground. I made sure that there was no paint, so I've got a good ground. I also connected it to, I don't want to show, I don't, you guys can find the ground. It's pretty easy to find. And then I just hid the wires, and that side's connected, so we are good to start it. Hopefully it should work. No. For some reason, it wouldn't start the first time, but I turned it off and turned it back on, and it looks like they are working. Oh, man. I gotta pull it in the garage to get a good view of them, but they do look blue-ish. So, let me just go ahead and finish wiring these up and, well, making sure everything is hidden and everything, and then I'll go ahead and pull it in the garage and we'll take a look. Okay, so that's on that side. I hit the wires down there, ran them through the back, and put it there, and there you go. Just by looking at it, you can not really tell there's really much done aside from seeing the ballast. I'm gonna go and pull it in the garage and take a look. Okay. There we go. The one thing you are going to notice, there is some flickering. It's because I need to get the DRL cancelers. I ordered them. They just have not come in yet. But it's a simple plug-in after that point. But there's that. There is a buzzing sound. I think that's because of the DRL cancelers as well. So once I get on there, I'll go have to reshoot a video just to do an update on that. But yeah, okay, well, the whole install took a little over an hour, maybe an hour and 10, hour and 15. Wasn't too hard, just a matter of getting my big ass arms in the wheel well and doing that. But overall, I think once I get the DRL flicker cancellers in there, it'll be pretty nice. Okay. Well, once again, this is Plumb by Beaner. If you like this video, go ahead and subscribe to me. I'm going to be doing other videos for my car here soon, so stay tuned. Thanks. Here's the headlights, or the high beams. It's crazy. Hopefully I don't blind people.